Hello and welcome to yet another episode of Two Bits, a program where I pledge my two pennies on different subject matters. In this episode, I want to talk about France, a country whose culture, heritage, philosophies I absolutely adore and respect. Recently, France has been a victim of multiple terror attacks, and here are three of the deadliest ones from those. The first of these attacks took place on January 2015. Terrorists opened fire on the headquarters of a satirical magazine titled Charlie Hebdo in Paris on 7th January, along with four more places across France. Three of the four perpetrators involved were later chased down and killed by police on 9th January. The remaining suspect is still on the run. Overall, 20 people lost their lives in the tragic incident. Responsibility for the attack was claimed by Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. The terrorist organization said the attacks were carried out to punish Charlie Hebdo for publishing a caricature of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in one of its earlier issues. Now, I am a Muslim and I most definitely love my Prophet. But killing people because my love has been defamed is a psychological perversion I fortunately do not have. Let me be more specific. If any individual, regardless of his or her religion, is suffering from such perversion, he or she must be given immediate medical attention. Allow me to elaborate a bit further. Suppose X and Y are two men and A is some other entity. Now X loves A just the way a devout Muslim should love the Prophet. Whereas Y is defaming A. Now there are two possibilities. If X is secured in his opinion about A, X would know that Y is ranting and can only pray to God for the enlightenment of Y. However, if X is insecure in his feelings and opinion or is uncertain about A, the words or actions of Y would invoke his deepest fears and anxieties, that is, of finding his beliefs to be mere illusions. The Charlie Hebdo shooting and any form of violence staged as a protest against the defamation of a loved one are examples of the latter kind. They do not have even an atom's worth of justification whatsoever. The second one in the list is also the single deadliest terrorist attack in French history so far. It took place just 10 months down the road from the Charlie Hebdo incident. Multiple shooting and grenade attacks occurred on 13th November. Among the locations targeted were a music venue, a stadium and several bars. 90 people were killed in just one of those attacks at a concert show. Altogether, 130 people died and more than 350 people were wounded. The responsibility was claimed by the Islamic State, more popularly known as ISIS. Now, I have repeatedly said on my blog at WordPress that the acts of ISIS are more satanic than any acts we have attributed to Satan so far. Soon, I hope to upload an entire episode debunking ISIS and their perverted doctrines. And finally, the last of these attacks took place on the Bastille Day this year. One man drove his 19-ton lorry into the crowds gathered to watch the fireworks in Nice. By the time police managed to shoot the driver down, he has already run over hundreds of people, killing 84 and injuring more than 200. Not just France though. In the period described in the video, countries like USA, Belgium, Turkey and Bangladesh have also been victims of terrorism. Worldwide, acts of terrorism have also left countries like Syria, Libya, Egypt, Iraq, Afghanistan and Pakistan, among many others, in a complete or partial state of paralysis. Perhaps a mass revolution of ideas would change the scenario, or perhaps not. But I cannot tell unless I have tried. So I'm saying no to violence, bloodshed and anarchy. How about you? Thank you for your time. Please subscribe so you can check out my next video. Take care till then. This is Amit Rahman signing off.